For those of you that may be new to yin, a yin practice is a more contemplative practice. It has Taoist roots. So if you think of that black and white symbol, the Tao, that's the yin and yang symbol. Yin is the feminine, it's the darker, it's the softer, it's the shadow, it's the slower side of things. Yang or yang is the masculine, it's the solar, it's the fire, it's the mobile. We spend probably much, if not most, of our time in yang energy, whether we're at work, at play, in our exercise. So a yin practice is to bring balance to our life, to our mind, to our body. Another aspect of a yin practice is that we target the connective tissue of the body. So that includes the tissue of your joints, your ligaments, the tissue that attaches bone to bone, your tendons to a certain degree, the attached muscle to bone, also the fascia. And the fascia is this really cool tissue that they're discovering more and more about. It's this fluid-filled web-like tissue throughout the entire body. And a yin practice can really help stimulate and stress these tissues in a healthy way. So bring your awareness to your breath. I start all my classes this way with breath. I want you to use the breath to help you settle into your body. As you join us, we're on our backs in starfish. Use the breath to help you set aside the past, set aside the future. Just allow yourself to reconnect to the present moment. Pay close attention to your breath, noticing the quality of your inhalation as well as your exhalation. Are they full? Are they expansive? Are they slow? Do they move in and out of the body with ease? Or do they get stuck or hung up anywhere? When you're ready to move on from the breath, I want you to take a moment to notice your physical body. Notice if there are any places of tension, there are places that feel sore or tender, or that feel particularly good today. Each exhale, giving more and more of your weight to gravity. From your physical body, move into your emotional body. Check in with how you're feeling on this Friday, May 1st, 2020. And there's no need to consider why you might be feeling one way or another. Just notice what the feelings are. From your emotional space, move into your mental space. You notice we start with the physical, then we move to the emotional, which is a little more subtle, and then from there we move to the mental, which is even more subtle. Here, notice your thoughts. Notice where they want to take you without trying to change or alter them. Yang or Yang energy is the architect, the engineer, the problem solver. Our Yin energy is more like the naturalist. We observe without interrupting, without changing or needing to fix anything. Come back to your breath. And with your next exhale, bring a little movement to the fingers and the toes. This is how we communicate with the body that we are moving out of rest and into effort. When you're ready, I want you to roll to one side or the other. Just coming all the way over to one side. And then with as little muscular effort as possible, I want you to press yourself away from the floor. We'll meet on hands and knees as we set up for the right side. I'll be on my left side in an attempt to mirror you. So I want you to step your right foot forward and take care here that you stack the right knee over the ankle. We're coming into what Yin calls low flying dragon. It's a type of lunge. So be mindful of where your hips are. We want the hips at least a little bit in front of the back knee. That'll give you an iliopsoas stretch. So for low flying dragon, we bring our hands to the inside of the right foot. And you can even take that foot a little bit wider if that gives you more space. But we keep the right knee stacked. You might be on palms. If that feels too deep, then maybe you come up to fingertips. You can use a block. If you want to go lower, if lower feels appropriate, you can come onto forearms, using a block or not. And we'll be here for a minute or two. Inside of the Yin practice, we want to use as little muscle engagement as possible. Now, as you find your expression of this pose, I want you to check in with the level of sensation you may be feeling anywhere in the body, probably the hips. On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 is pain, 1, you're not feeling very much. I want you around a 3. So there is sensation. There might even be a little discomfort, but you're not in pain. You can still keep the breath slow and steady. It's important that we remain connected to our parasympathetic nervous system. You can just let your head hang there. Depending on where you're at in the pose, you might stack your fists, maybe the head will rest there. Pillows and blankets, if you don't have a yoga block, they can be good props. And as we maintain stillness inside of effort, this is where we cultivate those Yin qualities, like patience, holding space, accepting. Now, of course, some muscles have to be engaged in order to maintain the pose. You're propping yourself up with your arms, of course, right? They're engaged. But hopefully in the hips, you're able to release some tension there. Now you can always, always leave the pose before I cue a departure. If you feel like you need a break, back out for a breath or two, maybe you get back in. It's important that you listen to your body. It doesn't matter what anyone else is doing or not doing. It doesn't matter what you did yesterday or what you may do tomorrow. Keep your breath slow and steady, full and expansive. And if it's appropriate for your practice to give this two more breaths, I want you to take two more slow, deep, generous breaths, and we'll move on. From our low flying dragon, we're moving into sleeping swan. Sleeping swan in yin is the same as pigeon in another format. So keep this right leg in front, but we're moving the foot to the inside of the mat and we're coming onto the shin. We'll leave our left leg, the leg behind us, we're keeping it extended. Now, depending on how the knee feels, you might want a pillow or a block or a stack of books underneath your right hip, because that'll displace some of your weight, so then not as much weight is on the knee, and that lifts you up a bit. Here in pigeon, you want to make sure that you keep your weight centered between the two legs. There can be a tendency to sink or shift your weight into the side of the bent leg. Resist doing that. When you feel like you have your legs in place, the sleeping part of the swan is folding forward. Maybe you come onto elbows. Maybe you come further, resting your forehead on the backs of your hands. But here in sleeping swan, you relax where you can. Just taking care that you keep your weight centered between the legs, tucking that extended leg all the way underneath you. If you can, be more on top of the knee and not so much on the inside. Always keeping in mind, this is your practice. You know what you're experiencing. And we want to listen to the body's whispers so that we don't have to listen to its screams. So that's really important in a yin practice, because we do maintain the pose. So you want to find an expression of the pose in which you can remain, keeping that breath slow and steady. There's effort, there is sensation, but you're not white knuckling the pose. The reason less muscular engagement stimulates the connective tissue is because when you're engaging the muscle, you're protecting the joint, which is really important when we're moving around. But when we're holding poses, if we can release that muscle engagement, we're putting more stress, more stimulation in the connective tissue. At your angle, I can see the front of you, but I can't really see your hips or legs. It looks like you're centered. Yes, that looks, you're centered. Yeah, as long as you're not, and it doesn't look like you are, as long as you're not sinking into that right hip, you're good. And it looks to me like you're centered. You have your weight between both legs. And I haven't forgotten about the rest of you. We are still here in this sleeping swan. If it's appropriate, I want you to take three more breaths. When you come to your last breath here in pigeon, whether that's one breath or three, we'll be moving into half butterfly. And to get to half butterfly, you will shift or sink into that right hip, and you'll carefully and slowly slide that extended leg more forward. We'll be in an upright position, our weight on both sitting bones. We're keeping the right leg bent, your foot, you know, just close to the left inner thigh. And I want you to sit up nice and tall, and when you're ready with an exhale, you'll fold forward. And stay hinging in the hips. Keep your spine straight as long as you can. Once you can't go any further, go ahead and let gravity take the weight of your head, your shoulders. You can round the back. This is another place where it can be appropriate to have props, to have blocks so that you can rest your head. I sometimes like to stack my fists on top of each other. And be mindful as we hold the pose for an extended period of time. Sometimes time and gravity take us where we need to be. We stay at a three because we gently nudge our limits. But sometimes the longer we're in a pose, the more intense it feels. Be mindful of where you're three on a scale of 1 to 10. A three represents your edge. So we want to go to the edge, we want to nudge it, but we don't want to fall off the cliff, okay? Release tension in the neck if you can. Just let your head hang there, let it rest on your hands or the floor. Keep your breath slow and steady. Deliberate and methodical. And we're just allowing ourselves to be a witness of our experience without expectation. You can just sit in curiosity. And with your next inhale, I want you to reach through the top of the head, the crown of your head. Bring your torso back to vertical as you sit up. And then this right leg has been bent for quite a while, so slowly straighten it and make your way back to starfish. This is where we rest from effort. In a yin practice, we take turns. We effort for a while, and then we rest, and then we go back to effort. So slowly find your way back to starfish. Arms and legs extended, feet and hands wider than the edges of your mat. And this is where we notice how we were affected by the first dive of that series. Maybe there's a sense of heat or density present that you didn't feel before. Maybe there's heat or some other sensation. And from Meister Eckhart, if the only prayer you say in your entire life is thank you, that would suffice. All you have to do here is rest and breathe. Just let your thoughts continue to float by like clouds in the sky. give your starfish two more breaths. When you arrive at your second exhalation, you can bring a little movement to the fingers and the toes. And this time, take care to roll to the opposite side from before in an effort to bring balance to how we move, to how we get up. When you've rolled to that other side, we'll make our way onto hands and knees like before as we set up for the second side of low flying dragon. I'll be stepping my right foot forward, you your left, in an attempt to mirror each other. That's kind of a funny angle to do that, but we want the knee stacked over the ankle. That'll provide stability for the knee. And you choose how deep to go. If you don't want to go so deep, then that back knee, it just needs to be a little closer to the front foot. When you feel like you have your legs where you need them, you're bringing both hands, maybe fists, fingertips, elbows, to the inside of that left foot. Just let your head hang heavy. Use whatever props you may need or want. Just allow yourself to settle in. Your breath is a great barometer. So if the breath becomes more shallow, if it becomes quicker in pace, you might be too deep. We want to remain engaged with our parasympathetic nervous system. We're setting aside adrenaline and cortisol, all things having to do with our sympathetic nervous system. Let's be inside of rest and digest. We allow time and gravity to be our partner inside of a yin practice. As we hold space and honor what's available without needing it to be some other way. Keeping your breath expansive and slow. Be mindful of your edge, noticing if it changes the longer we remain inside the pose. Begin to bring discernment to this second side. If it felt a little tighter, if it felt trickier to get into a deep expression, you might need to be here another couple of breaths. If it felt a little easier to access, then don't stay as long. From our low flying dragon, we'll be making our way to sleeping swan. On the same side, always go slow. Sometimes the transitions are more uncomfortable than the poses themselves. We're keeping the left leg in front, coming onto the shin. It's most likely that front shin is at an angle. The foot is towards the pelvis. We keep our right leg extended. Take care that your weight is centered between the two legs. When you feel like you have your foundation where it needs to be, then you can fold forward as you settle into sleeping swan. keeping that breath slow and steady. Here, the hips are our target area. You may feel tension in your glutes, the outside of the left hip, as the femur, your thigh bone, it's externally rotated, an inflection, because we're folded forward. Your right hip is an extension. So if you have tight quadriceps or a tight iliopsoas muscle, that's your hip flexor, then you may be feeling tension across the front of your right thigh, your hip. Release as much of the neck as you can. I know your shoulders might be inside of effort if they're helping to prop you up where you need to be. Elbows are doing the propping, but your shoulders have to stay engaged so that they're not sinking towards the ears. With each inhale, bring in as much air as you possibly can. Just receiving your inhalation with your entire body. As you let go of your exhalation, release it with your entire body, letting go of every last drop of breath. Begin to bring discernment to this second side of your sleeping swan. Same principle applies. If this side felt tighter, you don't want to stay as long, as we aim to bring a balance, physical balance. If this side felt a little easier to access, then maybe it's time to make your way to half butterfly. Just honoring your timing, your experience. When you're ready for half butterfly, you'll shift into the left hip and slowly bring that back leg forward, letting it extend or reach out to the side. Giving yourself time to feel both sitting bones rooted into your mat, sitting up nice and tall, shoulders down, away from the ears. And when you're ready, hinging in the hips, drawing your navel towards your mat. And when you can't go further, just let the spine round. Let gravity take the weight of your head and shoulders. Finding your way to your expression of half butterfly. Release any tension in the ankle, the toes. I noticed I was, keeping my foot kind of winged out. I studied dance, so that's what dancers do to have pretty ankles. but it doesn't matter here, and we want to relax all the muscles that we can, anything that we don't need, while maintaining the pose. Our yin practice encourages us to be still, to access sensations that may take a while to notice. When we slow down, we can often notice a bit more about the moment, about what's going on. Slow, steady, deep breaths. Begin to bring discernment to the second side of your half butterfly. You might choose to stay 1 to 4 more breaths, just depending on what's happening for you. When you are ready to leave the pose, do so the same way as before, reaching through the crown of the head. Of course, using your hands, your arms to press the torso up away from the body. Encourage you to keep the eyes closed in the transitions, especially since you know where you're headed. You're headed back to starfish, back home to this resting pose where we set aside effort. Here we hold space to notice how we were affected by the second side, or if we were affected. In a yin practice, we call this the rebound. When you've been inside of effort for a space of time and then you go back to rest, it's the rebound that we notice. It's the settling or the resettling of your bones, your muscles, the connective tissue, the organs. And then our prana, as we say in yoga, or some might say chi. And that just means your energy, your life force. You can sense that flow in the body. When we move into poses, when we move out of poses, we're clearing the way for our prana to move freely. Contentment is falling in love with your life, Swami Rama. Allow yourself to be. Here for a couple of more breaths. With your next exhale, bring a little movement to the fingers and the toes. We'll remain on our backs for our last pose, but we'll move into it slowly. So when you're ready with an exhale, slide your legs into center, in towards each other. You can slide the arms down by your side. And then I want you to bring the soles of your feet to the mat. Just walk your feet in towards your sitting bones. And we're headed into happy baby. So your feet will come off the mat. Your legs will stay bent as you reach your hands, maybe first for the ankles. Feet are flexed like you're standing on the ceiling. Legs bent. Now, if you want to go deeper, you can wrap your index and middle fingers around your big toes. And you're letting the hands do the work of holding on. Of course, you know, we have to engage the shoulders, the muscles of our chest to reach for the feet. But once you're holding on, release the muscles of your chest. To go deeper, if that feels appropriate, you could bring your hands to the arches or the insides of the feet. That presses my knees a little closer to the mat. It's a bit more intense in the inner thighs and the groin area. And if there is anyone that needs to go deeper, you can take your hands to the outside edges of the feet. That for me, it's not a huge difference, but it's a little bit deeper for me. And that's a bit too much today. So I'm going back to the arches. But your head is just resting heavy on the mat. Your shoulders are relaxed. As your hands do the work of holding on, the weight of your arms kind of brings those knees closer to your mat. And you might notice, if you take your attention to your lumbar spine, to your lower back, it usually has a lordotic curve. It's in a bit of an extension or a back bend most of the time. But here in Happy Baby, the lower back, your lumbar spine, is in more flexion. So we're bringing that lower back into a different shape. And we want to keep the breath slow and steady. Full and expansive. And I want to encourage you to be here for five more breaths. You choose if that feels appropriate or not. But if it does, I want you to take five more inhales and five more exhales. As you partner with time and gravity, if that keeps you at a three, great. If it doesn't, then just do what you need to do to back out 5%. In your own time, when you arrive at that fifth or final exhale, you'll soften your feet towards the pelvis. You can bring the knees in towards each other as you bring your feet to the mat. And make your way one final time back to starfish. Notice what, if anything, feels different from before. See if you can begin to discern that rebound. And I want you in starfish just long enough to notice what there is to notice. And that might be a couple more breaths, it might be three or four. you feel like you've been in starfish long enough to notice, I want you to transition to your final relaxation pose. You could choose a more traditional corpse pose with the arms and legs close together, maybe even inside the edges of your mat, palms up. Some people like to rest in reclining butterfly. So finding your way to your final relaxation pose, a position that you can take that feels restful, a position in which you can remain. I am giving you a 5-minute shavasana. There is time, so let me mind the time. Just allow your eyelids to grow heavy, your jaw soft, your muscles more and more relaxed with each exhalation. When you hear the sound of the bells, that'll be your cue to make your way to the left side of your body for nurturing pose. Discontentment is the illusion that there can be something else in the moment. There isn't, and there can't be. The moment is complete. Deborah Adele. keep your eyes closed. Just slowly bring awareness and movement to your body. You can bring movement to the feet, the hands, the neck. As you keep your head on your mat, looking left and right. When you're ready for more movement, you could take a long body stretch, similar to a wake-up stretch in the morning. And when you're ready, keeping those eyes closed, I want you to roll to the left side of your body. Just giving yourself time here in nurturing pose. A reminder that we are surrounded by beginnings. Breath or two, as you feel ready, you can gently peel yourself away from the floor. Still, I encourage you to keep the eyes closed, keeping your focus on yourself. As you find your way to a seat, just take a moment, ground or root down through your sitting bones, your spine nice and tall. When you're ready, with an in-breath, take your arms and your face up towards the sky. And on your exhale, bring those palms together, hands to heart center. And I encourage you here to take a moment to honor yourself, practice, and your body. As you move off of your mat and into the rest of your day, may you cultivate peace and contentment wherever you go. Namaste.